Let me at the outset thank Almighty Allah, the most gracious, omnipresent, merciful, for the wonderful opportunity I have got this evening to be in the midst of the galaxy of the shining religious personalities on the dais. I am particularly thankful to SKSSF organization for having thought of me to inaugurate this forward foundation in the city, in the town of Kuttipuram. I just few seconds, 2 minutes I had seen the presentation of Forward Foundation, immediately I could grasp what is it about, what are you going to do about. I am extremely happy to mention that in Karnataka, SKSSF has adopted certain areas of Chanpatna of Ramnagar district, the district which I belong to. I come from Ramnagar district. About 25 years ago, I was the chief executive officer of the entire Bangalore district, comprising of 11 taluks, including Chanpatna. I know the entire topography of the whole place. This Forward Foundation, when the representatives like Aslam Faizi spoke to me, I was asking, what is it about that you are going to do? He was mentioning about the education status and our provide efforts to help, especially children out of school, children who are not being able to enroll in the schools. Though enrolled, they are not regular in attendance. Though they are attending the classes over after secondary school, the dropouts are there. Let me tell you very frankly that we almost got 71, 72 years have passed, we got independence. When the Indian Constitution was framed, was given effective on 26th January 1950. One of the directive principles of the state policy was that the state shall give free and compulsory education to the children up to the age of 14 within a period of 10 years from the date of commencement of the Constitution. This was the mandate given to the central government. This was the mandate given to the state governments of the whole country, that no center, no state shall allow children going uneducated. The time given was only 10 years from the date of commencement of the Constitution, which was in 1950. 10 years have passed, 20 years have passed, 30 years have passed, 40, 50, 60 years have passed. We are completing next year 70 years of Republic. Coming into force of the Constitution. No doubt that we have not been able to achieve 100% literacy all over the country, despite the constitutional provision. Unfortunately, had we made the right to education a fundamental right in 1950 itself, our country's face would have been entirely different. Unfortunately, the conditions of Muslims in particular in the country, when compared to other socio-religious groups, when compared to other communities, the performance of Muslims in education is extremely bad. We have Justice Rajendra Sachar Committee report on the education status of the Muslim community in the country. The findings of the Justice Rajendra Sachar Committee was that barring Kerala. Kerala, we salute the leaders here. We salute the religious heads. You have taken care to make this state literate, and you have educated. Unfortunately, in other parts in North India, and also in South India, including Karnataka, we had not made the substantial progress. Only when the Justice Sachs Committee felt that Muslims are backward, compared to even scheduled castes and the scheduled tribes, the government in UPA government took some affirmative actions and formulated certain schemes like pre-metric scholarship, post-metric scholarship, merit come means scholarship, so that our children at least get attracted to go to schools. No doubt, thousands of crores of rupees have gone all over the country. The enrollment has improved with this scholarship because I was, before retirement, I was heading the Department of Minority Affairs, Hajj and Waqf in the state of Karnataka. I was fully involved in the implementation of the minority welfare schemes, especially the education schemes. I was very deep into this. The enrollment has started going very well. Children were coming to the schools. Thereafter, after 8 years, the government in UPA appointed a committee called Post-Sachar Evaluation Committee, headed by Professor Amitabh Kundu. He is a professor from Jawaharlal Nehru University, to find out whether the schemes and the budget given to the states has really helped the targeted group. His finding, there were so many findings. I'm only focusing on education for the benefit of the Forward Foundation. The one of the findings of Professor Amitabh Kundu was, despite scholarships given by the various governments, despite the budgetary allocation given by the state governments, despite the good enrollment, over a period of years, when the children come to the secondary school, the dropout rate has not come down. This is something which should agitate the minds of the right-thinking people, should agitate the minds of the civil society, should engage the minds of the NGOs like Forward Foundation. This is one area I suggest you must do a lot. My feeling is, dropout rate, it is not possible for the government to go to every house, pick up the children, ensure their attendance, ensure that no dropout takes place. It is the job of the sensible Muslim community, the NGOs, all over the country to take care of the interests of education. This is about, I appreciate, I also help and assist the Forward Foundation. How you should enroll, 100% there should be enrollment. You must ensure 100% attendance. You must ensure that no dropout takes place. Finally, you must ensure quality education at primary level. If at all you want to bring about the educational empowerment of the Muslim community in the country. This is based on my own experience of 40 years in the state government and the central government and the research. As a Muslim, I feel what has gone wrong with the Muslim community in other parts of the country. I'm not referring to Kerala. Kerala has set an excellent example. We need to follow in other states the Kerala model of education. I appreciate and congratulate. I'm talking of North India, the South Indian Muslim conditions in the field of education. As a Muslim, I feel that education, the first verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed that Prophet Muhammad was pertaining to the acquisition of knowledge. Ikhra bismi rabbikal ladzi khalaq. Read in the name of thy Lord who has created the entire universe. He is the most merciful. He has created man out of a clot of blood. Further he says, Allah is merciful. He has taught man through pen, and he has taught people when they know not. No, the importance of acquiring education is so much emphasizing the religion of Islam, which I feel there may not be so much emphasis on the holy scriptures. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says, seek knowledge though it be in China. Seek knowledge from cradle to the grave. He further says, the ink of a scholar is more sacred than the blood of a martyr. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he says again, the acquisition of knowledge is a duty in the religion of Islam. It is for both men and women to acquire education so that they should become powerful. This message has come more than 1,440 years ago. And if you look at the Muslim condition in the field of education, we feel ashamed. We feel pain. What is happening? Why the masses of the Muslim community are going uneducated? This is the area where everyone has to work. I know the Kerala model, Kerala SKSSF is moving and trying to do something good in the field of education. I come from Karnataka. Karnataka, off late, we have a number of schemes to promote education. We are empowering the community of the various welfare schemes introduced by our Congress government at the time, now the coalition government. We have more than 200 to 300 residential schools. We have about more than 15 lakh children get scholarship. There are more than 350 students doing a post-graduation all over the world under the scheme called Overseas Scholarship Scheme. We are doing our best. We should think of the North India and other places. Unless the Muslims are educated in this country, we will not contribute good to this nation. The country, if a country has to be vibrant, if we want to establish a vibrant, inclusive society, we need educated people. Educated people, adequately equipped with the skill. The educated, the skilled people are necessary to ensure the social transformation. Educated people and the skilled people are necessary to ensure the economic transformation. If we want our poor masses to be empowered, education is the only weapon. Please, I am extremely happy to have participated in this program. I am extremely grateful that you are always in the area of helping children. Now we have the literacy, we are hardly 70% in the country, our literacy. We are much below the national average of 74%. You know, the percentage of Muslims in the higher institution is less than 3%. One out of 25 graduates enrolling for undergraduate courses is a Muslim. One student out of 50 postgraduate students enrolling in postgraduate courses is a Muslim. The representation of Muslims in jobs is equally bad. The representation of Muslims in the institution of national importance is less than 3%. The only which I have seen, my own experience of research, of administrative experience, I have come to the conclusion there are three issues facing the community today. One is educational backwardness. We should remove illiteracy from the face of the community. For that, any investment in education is worth investment, number one. Number two problem facing the Indian Muslims is the poverty. The dropout is because of pitiable economic backwardness of the parents. That's how children are dropping out. They are poor. They have no three meals a day. That's how the children are moving out. This poverty has to be tackled by poverty alleviation programs. We have any number of schemes by the center and the state government, which I'm not going to discuss. Finally, the greatest problem facing the Indian Muslims today is the lack of unity. We are all divided horizontally, vertically. We have any number of firqas. This is virtually killing our progress. I must be happy to mention, I am accompanied by three persons from Bangalore. One, Mr. Mujahid Ali Baba, who is the founder of Sadae Ittehad, the voice of Kumbh, voice of the unity in the state of Karnataka. We have been able to bring seven to eight heads of different schools of thought together in the last 8 years. We are doing all initiative to promote unity. I have with me also one Mr. Sayyid Sardar, who is the General Secretary of Sadae Ittehad. Now I feel illiteracy has to be tackled, poverty has to be removed. These two things are possible, provided we are united. وَاتَسْمِ بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. We should follow the religion of Islam very firmly. We should not get divided. There is a strength in the unity through this platform, in the presence of all shining religious personalities. I appeal to all of you, the whole Muslims of this country, to sing your differences. Come together, get united, promote education, remove poverty, make our country a powerful country in this world. With these few words, I am extremely thankful to Mr. Ibrahim Jokete, the all organizers of the SKSSF, for the opportunity you have given to me, for the love that you have shown, and for the honor you have done. Once again, I thank all religious leaders for this wonderful opportunity. Once again, I thank you very much. Thank you so much.